nobody wants to build manual machines anymore. Hello, Yuri Tsenkende here. In this video, we're going to introduce absolutely new type of machine for turning. But before we come to the details, let's talk about machine types currently present on the market. At first, let's look at CNC machines and their pros and cons. The main advantage of CNC machine is productivity. Basically, you need to spend some time for programming, setup, and after that point, you push the button and basically machine gonna do the job for you. Simple mechanical design, spindles, drive, even coolant flow controlled by electronic drives. Some machines is so simple, they do not even have a gears. Regarding disadvantages, mainly CNC machine much more complicated from electronic point of view, and also usually it's much more expensive compared to the manual one. Manual, somebody calls them engine lathes. That type of machine originated first and still very popular on the market. And as everything, it has own advantages and disadvantages. What is the main advantage of manual lathe? Relatively easy to use. One of the easiest machine to run, especially when you're making basic parts. But when you start to go to more complicated parts or high production run, all the advantages basically disappear and CNC start to outperform manual equipment. For sure, more complicated tasks will require high skill operator, but even so, he don't really need to know any programming language, he don't need to know the G-code used on CNC machines. Manual machine also does not have complicated electronic components like servo motors, drives, so which means the cost of maintaining and running that machine is less. Those of you guys who's running CNC machines will know what I mean. And the last one, the price. Manual machine right now about 2 to 3 times less money compared to similar size CNC machine. Now let's talk about negative sides of manual machine. First one is low productivity. Manual machine usually does not require too much time for setup and programming. So when you're doing repair work or small runs, manual machine might even outperform CNC. However, when you start to do big runs or doing complicated surfaces, manual machine simply not there. Extremely complicated mechanically. Have you ever opened gearbox, feedbox, or apron on manual machine? What do you see there? Gears, spline shafts, clutches, and gears again. Do you know why? Any machine should provide wide range of speeds and feeds. You should be able to maintain constant surface speed no matter the diameter of workpiece, big or small. In order to do so, machine rely on mechanical aid of set of gears and pulleys. It is normal for headstock to have 18 to 24 speeds and have 20 to 40 gears inside. All of them different. Same apply to the feed box and an apron. The idea of manual machine stays the same for about last 100 years. Those days machine might look a little bit better. Manufacturer might use different colors, use nice paint, safety guards, use more advanced components. However, principle stays the same. It is 100 years old. And the last disadvantage we're gonna talk is coming directly from the problem we just discussed. Nobody wants to build manual machines anymore. In reality, the selection is limited to a couple countries from Asia. For machine tool builders, especially building generic CNC machines, is much more easier and most important profitable to grab ready-to-go assemblies, purchase them, cartridge assembly, tool changer, ball screws, make casting, put it all together, assemble it, machine ready to go. Does not work for manual machine manufacturing. Each gear or shaft there is machine specific, hundreds of them. As a result, we have extremely mechanically complicated machine which sold for 2 to 3 times cheaper compared to CNC version. Who willing to produce such a machine and where quality you think gonna be? Based on this, is it any future for manual equipment? We think so. Repair facility, custom part manufacturers, or even production shops making simple parts like flanges, nipples, or pins still require manual equipment. Many of them have no reason to own and run expensive and complicated CNC equipment. All this brings us to an idea to create a smart lathe. Here is what we have here. We have a machine, looks like a regular lathe. We do have a headstock, carriage, compound, ordinary control, tailstock, and you might ask, what are you talking about? It is a manual lathe. And you're right, it is a manual lathe. All other machine tool builders, even building hybrid CNC machines, trying to fit as many features into the control as possible. And by doing so, they going away from simplicity. Sooner or later, machine become a CNC. Show that machine to your manual machinist and see what he gonna say. Where he gonna start? He will see 100 buttons, whole bunch of flashing lights, where to start, and all what you need to do just to cut a simple washer. Our concept is different. Eliminate all complicated mechanical components and replace them with up-to-date modern servo drives and ball screws. Keep machine control the same as a manual lathe in both ergonomic and, most importantly, feelings. So when you're using the machine, you feel no difference with regular engine lathe. And to finalize it, we built into the control few pre-programmed cycles, like taper thread cutting, for example, to increase machine efficiency. So let's look closer on the machine. We're gonna start with bed. We have 400 millimeter or 16 inch wide bed. In comparison, average machine will have about 12 to 14 inch wide bed, and so our machine with combination of extra wide carriage will outperform comparable manual lathe dramatically in terms of rigidity. Bed is precisely ground. We have single V at the front and we have a flat on the back. Bedway hardness is about 55 Rockwell. Center distance available 40, 60 and 80 inches. Now we're coming to the headstock. What we have here? Single head, 3 speeds, 6 gears. VFD controlled, forget about chattering. The low gear has 20 RPM minimum. Gonna provide you huge amount of torque needed for heavy machining or large diameter drilling. Going to the middle position, 55 to 650. Range is enough for doing general machining, and on the top end we have 2000 RPM maximum, which is great for doing finish passes and polishing. The swing of the machine is 20 inch and we have two options for the spindle bore. The standard one is 3.25 inch or 80 millimeter, and bigger diameter is 4.125 or 105 millimeter in diameter. Moving down from the headstock, we go into the feedbox area, and what we see here? Nothing. So basically, behind this cover, we have servo motor, which is drive large diameter ball screw, providing motion to our carriage travel left and right. Very simple designs, no gears, no nothing. Moving to the right, we have a compound, ordinary four-position tool post. We can also get quick change 40-position tool post available of two different sizes. Compound does not swivel, and we're gonna talk about it a little bit later. And moving down, what we have here? We have ordinary manual lathe type of control. So we have our spindle direction switch, rapid buttons, emergency switch, feed selection switch, and most importantly here we have hand wheels for our cross slide and longitudinal travel. In reality, those handles does not connect it mechanically to the cross slide screw. In reality, it's a manual pulse generators. But what most important here, we set up this machine so you can adjust the resistance on those handles. And if you would like to feel manual machine, you can increase the resistance on the handles and you're gonna start to feel it. So instead of freewheeling, you have feel of manual lathe. Moving to the right here, we do have a tailstock. Nothing special here, just a regular one. We have Morse 5 taper inside. We have a lock handle, quill lock handle, nothing really special. On the back side of the machine, we do have K cable carriers protecting wiring going to the carriage area from flying chips, and also behind it we do have automatic lubrication pump which will provide oil to our carriage, crosswire and ball screws, worry-free. You don't need to pull manual handle on the pump, nothing like that. If oil goes down, it will give you the sound, so you never miss lubrication. And to finalize, we come into heart of our machine is our control. On the top left area, we do have a spindle dial. In the middle, we do have spindle RPM indicator showing you actual RPM getting on the spindle. Down below, we do have our spindle load gauge. On the right side, we do have two indicators showing us feed rate and travel rate for X and Z axis. Down below, we do have two gauges showing us each axis load. Digital readout which show us actual position for each axis X and Z. On the right hand side we do have our pre-programmed cycle buttons as well as our feed control. As you notice right now machine set up for Imperial system, but you can relatively easy switch it to metric. So all you need to do, click on gear here, and right here you can either select your radius or diameter settings, and also you can switch metric to Imperial. And in order to take effect, you would have to restart the machine. Below the screen, we do have our emergency stop button, hand wheel multiplier, and variable frequency drive spindle RPM control. So, machining time. First of all, let's try to use the machine in strictly manual mode. We're not going to use any pre-programmed cycles, so all what we have here is a handle control, our rapid control, and feed direction and spindle. That's it. So, what we're gonna do. Let's run machine probably at about 400-500 RPM. Crank the dial down a little bit and start the spindle. In the top area here we can see we have 530 RPM. Let's go a little bit more. So what we need to do now? We need to touch our zero. So it's actually already preset up for Z axis, Z zero, X axis, same thing. We come here, normal way, we're using the handles here. It's a little bit too coarse, so we have to switch to multiplier one. So we're touching our X axis, come back Z zero. Right about there. Let's try to do facing. Longitudinal handle, say 20 tau to the left. All what we need to do right now, we need to engage our crossfit handle. Right here we do have our feed rate. So let's set it up at 12 tau per revolution. And we simply engage in our cross direction. Done here. Now to come back, couple options here. We can either crank it back hand, or we can simply push our rapid button right here. So we have a new Z zero now. So now let's do Audi turning. Come back to our zero for X axis. Nothing really special we're doing, but we're running machine exactly the same way as we would run manual way. So let's remove say 30 tau per diameter. Again, Z zero, 30 tau on X, handle to the left. 12 tau per revolution. As you can see, we've done manual pass. We cut 2 inches long at 12 tau per revolution, exactly the same as manual machine. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna run automated machining cycle for Audi turning. We're gonna remove 100 tau in 2 passes for 2 inches long. So what we're doing here, we come back to zero, Z0 actually stays the same, so we just need to bring it back to zero here. And for X-axis, we would have to probably touch it again. Come back Z0. Right about there. Reset our X. So we're going to keep our feed rate at 12 tau per revolution. We're doing 2-inch long pass. We're doing 50 tau per pass, and we're doing 2 passes. From that point, we just click cycle button. We make sure we have zeros right there. Engage our spindle and simply move handle to the left. Machine automatically returned to zero position, feeds in and doing second pass. After that point, once it's finished, it's gonna clean up the face at the end of 2 inches, come back to zero and basically stop the cycle. But you would have to turn off the spindle manually. Cleaning faces now, come back to zero and stop. Green light shows you cycle is completed. The same principle applies to facing. All what we need to do, instead of selecting longitudinal direction, we would have to move the handle in up position. So as you can see, facing cycle is highlighted blue. So the next thing what we're gonna do here, we're gonna cut the thread on that diameter, but we do have a threading tool here. So let's change it. And just imagine, if you have a shoulder right here, what's the RPM you're gonna use? Probably 100 RPM. And you need to do that motion, you need to play in between your spindle control and half nut control, do the reverse. If it's imperial, you can simply disconnect your half nut, but if it's metric, you would have to do immediate pullback on your cross slide, switch direction of your spindle, so to prevent crash. Let's see how it's gonna work here in our smart ways. Same principle. Multiplier up, we're coming. We set up our zero for both axes. So here's our X0, and about here we do have Z0, reset them both. So we set up our zero. So what we're gonna do? We're switching to our threading cycle. Go into inch. Now we need to select our pitch, which is gonna be 11.5 threads per inch, right here. So we're gonna do it for 1.5 inch long. You know what, actually let's go 1.8 inch long. We're gonna do 10 tau per pass, and we're gonna do 16 passes. The total depth gonna be about 160 tau. Then we would have to click the cycle. We're probably gonna use a little bit less RPM. We don't wanna cut at 500. Let's do it maybe like 300. About here. And again, all what we need to do, just choose the direction. So we're doing right-hand thread, so we'd have to switch to the left. For the left-hand thread, you would have to switch to the right and start from the left side. All what we need to do right now, just stay and wait. Machine always come back to the same position and gonna stop when thread cutting is done. Here we go. thread is completed. So let's machine offset thread we just machined, and after that we're going to machine our taper thread. So right now we're going to machine our taper diameter. On regular ways, what you usually would do, you have a couple of options. First one, you can set up, if you have one, your taper attachment for a certain angle, and you would have to do some dialing and stuff, or you can use your top compound, but the same deal, you would have to dial it in, and you know how much usually time it takes. Now in our case, all what we need to do, we have to simply select our angle there, set up our zeros, set up the length, how many passes, how many per pass, push the button and basically stay aside and watch. So we're gonna do, say, Morse for taper on 1.5 inch long. Let's see how to do it. In that area we do have preset up, most common tapers. You need, say, like 7/24 or more staples. Right here we'll do 1.5 inch long. We're doing 20 tau per pass. And we will do, say, 4 passes. The last line show us the feed rate, so how many tau per revolution we're gonna do. So let's say we're gonna do 10 tau per revolution. We click on cycle. We have zeros right there, same deal, engage spindle, handle to the left. So machine flashing green right now, cycle is complete. We stop the spindle. As you can see, we spent just a couple minutes. We did not set up nothing. We just push few buttons and here we go. We do have Morse taper number 4 right here. The last step we're gonna show you, we're gonna cut the sample taper thread on it. And as you know, only machines with taper attachments able to do so, and you know again how much time it involved in it, especially when you have a shoulder at the end. Let's do it. First thing we need to do, we're going back to our threading tool. We're in manual mode right now. We cancel the cycle, crank it up a little bit, and find our zero again. So called it Z0 right here, and now we need to find our right here, our X0. So here is our start position. Let's do 1 inch long taper thread, 11.5 threads per inch. We click on our taper thread cycle, select NPT thread as an example, 11.5. We have 1.5 long, let's do it 1.0 inch. We're doing 10 tau per pass, and we're gonna do, say, 8 passes. Click on cycle. We're gonna crank down RPM a little bit. We don't want to run it at 600, but still do it at 300. Well, let's do it maybe even more, 500 RPM. Again, all what we're doing here, we move handle to the left. RPM. Try to do it on manual machine. You probably notice sometimes you experiencing the chattering during the cut. All what you're doing here, just crank this handle down, your chatter going away. So machine complete all 8 passes. Stop the spindle. And here we go. We do have a thread. And the final, what we're going to do here, we're going to do the heavy pass. So let's remove about 400 tau per diameter at about 10 tau per revolution. So here is our zero right there. Right there. Here you go. As you can see, machine can be used as a regular lathe, but when you want, you can simplify your work by using pre-programming cycles. And as you can see, they're very simple and you will never forget how to use them. Machine is very solid and in combination with 3-speed gearbox, it's capable of heavy cuts. We create a machine which uses minimum amount of mechanical parts compared to regular engine lathes, which means maintenance cost reduced dramatically. You might say now we have lots of electronic components, and if something goes wrong with them, it might cost a fortune to repair or replace. To make it clear, electronic components those days is very reliable, and it's a very small chance something goes wrong with them. However, if, say, something happens, drive fail, we can compare the price of individual drive probably to the price of individual gear on manual lathe. But to replace it, electrician would need just a few minutes. Just imagine how much will cost you to replace broken gears on your manual lathe, especially when you need to replace normally 2 gears if one is broken. We're going to post the tutorials how to use each cycle and each feature of that machines. More information and pricing always available on our website, which is stencanada.com. Thank you for watching this video and we'll see you next time.